Oh my gosh, guess what? Every grow has sent me a new product, and I can't wait to open this and see what's inside. Let's do this together. Oh my gosh, this is exciting. This is from Every Grow. Oh my gosh. Bring you in closer. We're using this today. So Every Grow has mill grinders, so you could grind your mill. And in my world and your world, it's Worm Chow time. So look at the different size filters they have. I saw one other worm farmer use this, and it was Dakin Gardens. Hi Karen. And oh my gosh, what do you think? Look at this one. I wonder what this super fine one will do to the worm chow. So we're gonna open this and let's go make worm chow. Oh my gosh, look guys, it has another filter. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wow. This oh my gosh, I love this. Let me get it out of here. Well, look, you know this is a bonus for me. It's not hard to lift. Wow. This is very impressive. Oh my gosh. Get out of here. This is amazing. This is gonna change my worm chow world. Let me put it up on this table. I mean, look at this thing. This is like, oh, pure beauty. Thank you. I'm floored. Oh my gosh, I love it. The size of the bucket, it comes with a bucket, which I wasn't sure. And which makes it so convenient because it fits perfect. So, okay, we gotta put this on, which will keep it secure. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. And okay, let me bring this down so I can show you the inner part. So, do you remember, now those of you that are new here, I'll put a picture up here. The last time I made worm chow in here, it was this giant cloud. I had to get out of here. I had to get a mask. It was such a disaster. Everything in here got covered in powder. Well, it just did. So I go make my worm chow outside. But here in Indiana, we have winters that could either be 20 below zero or torrential rains, and it just makes it very inconvenient for me to go out there in the winter. And you know, my flock, my herd, they still have to eat, and I sell my worm chow on my website, so I need something I can use indoors. So we're gonna give this a try today. I'm so excited. This to me is like gold. So let's give it a try, and I'm gonna learn how to change the little filters, because I'm gonna put this thing to the test. I wanna try it on the finest one. I wanna try a few of them. This is unbelievable. Very, very high quality product. Okay, let's go. So what do you think, guys? Got myself some cheaters. So before I use any machinery, obviously I always read the manual and make sure I am doing everything correct. All right, let's look at my ingredients that I'm going to use in the Every Grow. So we got beetroot. This is corn cob crumbles, chicken feed, oyster shell, dry molasses. This is my own worm chow. This is corn. And then we got regular oats that you feed horses. And then we got alfalfa. I am going to make the autumn blend with this. I am going to finish it off camera because, you know, I have some ingredients that are my secret that I don't tell everybody. But this is the basic ingredients for the worm chow, and we're going to try it in the Every Grow. and we're gonna see how it works.
So when I turn it on, it's loud. Obviously it's a machine, so I'll probably adjust the volume on the video so you guys won't hurt your ears. Okay, I just decided to bring you in. So there's an on and off button over here in the front, very easy. Obviously just boom, press it, and okay, you can see inside. So let's start this. Let's start with, I'm gonna work my way around. Well, you know the ingredients. I'll show you before I pour it in. Oh my gosh, have you noticed that white oyster shell? There is no cloud of powder in here. This is gonna make my winter worm farming so much easier. What do you think so far? I am so impressed. I can't believe it. And there's literally not a cloud of dust in here. So this powder here is a mineral that I like to add into my worm chow, and it's called azomite minerals. So I always add some to my worm chow when I'm making it. So I just threw it in here. So one recommendation I do have, guys, is that when you're using pellets like this size, I would just do them a little bit at a time. Don't pile it up because it's going to take forever to grind down, especially since I'm using the smallest mesh. So I'm going to show you how I've been doing it, and it's just a little bit at a time. Let me turn this thing on. This is definitely doable for me in the winter, especially if I get like a piece of cardboard and I just put it on top while I'm grinding. Let's see what it looks like.
Oh, wow.
So I would say that's a fine powder. Oh my gosh, look at this. Wow, I am so impressed. This has definitely been a game changer for me. What I would do next time is before I open it, I'll wait till it settles a while so the dust doesn't come out. But it is a 100% improvement. I mean, look at that. Wow. I'm going to try this size. This is like one size up. And I cannot believe how easy it is to change the meshes on this thing. So I tried the second size up, and as you can see, it made it a little thicker, but I have never made my worm chow to a complete powder. So I'm curious to see the third side up, because this size is probably what I used in my other machine. So I'm going to switch it to this one and I'm going to try it. I don't know, for some reason, my worms, like, they do better when it's not a fine powder. And I know some people like it fine powder, and that's great. You do it like that. But from my experience, this size has always been better. So I'm going to try that. Okay, for me personally, this is more like it. This is the consistency I like to make my worm chow. It's not fine powder. It's still kind of in little pieces. I just found that my worms just do better with that. I don't know why. I don't know. So I'll definitely be using this size. So, conclusion, my opinion, I love it. I love it. I love that it grinds everything. I love that I can do it indoors. I love that I can pick the size of the chow I want to make. I mean, from the medium size to even, you know, I don't know. I don't, maybe I'll make it that thick one day. I absolutely love it. Every girl, you've done a great job with this product. I plan to use it in my worm farm here for years to come, hopefully. And anyone who watches this, I'm going to link this product in my Amazon store. You can shop through for anything on Amazon through my link. It does not cost you a single dime extra, which is awesome. They do give me a small commission. Anything I make on Amazon, I always reinvest it back into my wormery, because these guys need supplies to eat. So I would grab you one, though, because I don't think there are that many out there. And I know that people are going to snatch them up the minute they see this video. So I'm impressed. Thank you, Every Girl. I love it. I appreciate it. I know my worm farming friends are going to love it. So thank you, and subscribe and check out my other worm channel. And I will see you next time.